हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द रोमन एम्पायर एंड वी हैव कवर्ड द मेन टॉपिक्स टिल द सेकेंड सेंचुरी एडी एंड वी हाईलाइटेड द पॉइंट दैट द थर्ड सेंचुरी एडी इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यू कैन से वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टाइम पीरियड इन द डिवीजन ऑफ द अर्ली रोमन एम्पायर एंड द लैटर रोमन एम्पायर. द रोमन एम्पायर फेस्ड सम डिफिकल्टीज इन द थर्ड सेंचुरी एडी. And there was political instability in the Roman Empire because in the 3rd century AD there was a rise of a more powerful kingdom, more aggressive kingdom in Iran known as the Sassanid Empire. Also, the Roman Empire had to face some difficulties from the tribes of the German areas which pushed the Roman out of the areas near the river Danube which used to be a part of the Roman Empire. The political instability was such that in a time period of about 47 years, we see the rise and fall of 25 emperors of the Roman Empire. So this time period is very important to divide the early Roman Empire and the latter Roman Empire. Now when we'll talk about the new developments in the latter Roman Empire, we will also try to highlight some points as an overall concept about the Roman Empire related to the gender issues, related to the family issues, the society, the trade relations, the economy, the culture, okay, the different types of worships. So we'll try to highlight all these points slowly and gradually. So first of all, we will like to highlight the family. How was the family in the Roman Empire? So, in the Roman Empire, the family was a nuclear family in which most of the adults did not stay with their family. Okay, so they used to stay elsewhere. They did not stay with their families. But when we talk about a marriage, it was a nuclear family. When we talk about a marriage issues, so male and female were categorized as different financial entities. Okay, because even after marriage, the women had their rights of property in their patriarchal homes. Okay, so this was very important. Now, it's not that women were given such a status, so women were everywhere, you can say, peaceful and they entertained each and every rights. They had to face some difficulties in different periods because as highlighted by Saint Augustine, he says that his mother was beaten up by his father many a times. Okay, and this was the story of many other women in the Roman Empire. So from here we can have a view that even though the women were given a given status, important status was important of women, but it was not so that they did not face any difficulties. Now when we come about the, you can say, culture, it was a diverse culture. The Roman culture was a diverse culture with different types of you can say different types of gods were being worshipped, like Jupiter, like Juno, Mars. These were the gods who were worshipped in the Roman Empire. Also, Judaism was a very important religion, okay, of the Roman Empire. So there were different religions prevailing during that time. Different languages being spoken, Celtic, Punic, Berber. These were the languages which were spoken by the German people, by the Roman people in different areas, in different parts of the Roman Empire. The most important thing about any empire is its trade and its economy. So, to create such a vast empire as a Roman Empire, the economy needed to be strengthened. Okay, and the economy was, you can say, the economy was stable due to different factors. Like you can say, not monopoly, but a huge production of some products like wheat, like grape wine, olive oil. These all things were very important for the Roman Empire, which helped it to flourish in the field of trade and commerce. Even these things were produced differently in different parts of the Roman Empire. Like Italy was popular for its wheat. Okay, Campania was a region which was famous for grape wine. Spain, which used to be a part of Roman Empire, and later on Northern Africa, became an important production center of the olive oil. Also, when we study about these things, we come to know about amphora. Amphora is a vessel in which liquid materials were transported from one place to another. And more particularly, we come to know about Dressel 20, which was named after an archaeologist, Henrik Dressel. The Dressel 20 was a vessel which was used to, which was used to keep olive oil, and trade was done. The olive oil trade was done in the Dressel 20 containers. Okay, so this is very important. Now, when we see about the culture, the god, the different different products of trade, we also need to know about the society, that how was the society built up in the Roman Empire. So the major categorization, if we do the major categorization of the Roman Empire, on the first level you keep the senators, on the second level you keep the equites, or they were called the knights. Okay, so these were the equites, were the people who were given admission to the cavalry of the Roman Empire because of the property they owned. They were huge landowners, as were the senators. But the only difference with the senators and the knight was that the senators were large landowners and they did not indulge in different activities, but the knights indulged in different activities like trade, like shipbuilding, and many other many different activities. Now on the third level you keep the medium class people, and on the fourth level you keep the slave. Slave is a very important point for the Roman Empire. Very, very important point for the Roman Empire. We hear about different types of practice of slave. Okay, in the Roman Empire. So we will try to highlight the main important points related to the slave culture of the Roman Empire. The root of the slavery in the Roman Empire was of ancient times. Okay. It can be traced to more ancient times. But when during the 1st century AD, there was peace prevailing in the Roman Empire, 1st and 2nd century AD, there was a decline in the number of slaves. Okay. So, but now the slaves were needed to work in different farms, to work in factories, to work in different, different units of production. So, now people thought that besides, to keep away the expenses to have a slave for a complete year, they transformed went on in the search of paid laborers. Okay, paid laborers, or they freed their slaves. Okay, they freed their slaves and they worked. They used to acquire people who would work for salaries. So, but before that thing. There were many different, many different things being talked about the slave culture, because even after the establishment of Christianity in the 4th century AD, no one opposed the culture of slave, and many different things were practiced with the slave, which is very important for us to know. There are different historians who say that the slaves were kept in different, different works, okay, and they were put in a group of 10 to 20 to do a certain kind of work, and they were regularly inspected, okay, but after that, all the slaves were put together with chains in their legs and in their hands tied. Okay, so it was not a very good sign for such a huge culture, for such a vast empire. So many different things have been talked about the slave culture. We have also seen the traces of slave breeding. We also come across evidences of slave breeding, in which the slaves were encouraged to produce more and more children for the work of so that their children could work as slave for their the owners. So this is a very important concept related to the slave culture of the Roman Empire. Also, they were stamped on their skin. Okay. So that they could not run away, or they can be found out easily. They could be traced out easily if they tried to run away. Okay. So these were different things which were related to the slaves. These were the different issues which were related to the slaves. And is a question, and it's a matter of debate about the glory of the Roman Empire and the culture of the slave. Okay, so this is very important topic that we come across in the glory of the Roman Empire. Also, now when we talk about the different changes which occurred in the latter Roman Empire, we see different rulers coming into existence and doing different types of work, like introducing new currencies, like building a new empire, now building a, you can say, a new capital. Among these, Constantine is a very important ruler who introduced a new kind of currency, and also he built a new, you can say, capital, which was known as Constantinople or the Byzantine Empire, by which now the Roman Empire is known, Byzantine. Okay, so the capital Constantinople was made by Constantine, and this is known as that from that time only, or we can say now when we talk about the Roman Empire, this is known as the Byzantine Empire. So these are the things which we needed to discuss about the Roman Empire. We will have an overview. Now we all have an overview about how the Roman culture, how the Roman civilization, you can say Roman Empire developed, what were the different practices that were done in the Roman Empire. And now in the next or the upcoming lectures, we will try to learn that after the 6th century AD, there was a clash between the, you can say, there was a clash between the Roman Empire and the Sassanid Empire, huge clash, and the power went into the hands of the Arabs. And we'll also talk about the rise of Islam, which is a very important, you can say, event in the world history topics now. So in the next lecture, we'll try to learn about the rise or advent of Islam in the world, and what were the major changes which occurred with the coming of Islam, and how did the, you can say, how did the face of the world history change from the advent of Islam. So till then, keep studying, okay, and we'll meet in the next lecture with the rise of Islam. Thank you. Atha Shri Mahabharat Katha.